Hello YouTube, welcome to Open TTD with Lieutenant Joker. We're right back where we left off. We're near our docks, right in the south here, with our two little fishing boats. And what we're going to do at first is check how these guys are doing and whether we need any more of them down here. I think I wanted to... Let me check. I think I needed another one down here. Oh yes, we need another one. What does another one cost? 15,000, we should have that soon. So let's speed this up. I want to max out our lines before we do anything else. And while this happens and these guys collect money, I can tell you a little bit of about what I'm trying to do next. I looked at the cargo payment rates and I looked at, okay, what could we actually take on to make a lot of money? Well, fish, of course, as you can see, needs to arrive at speed. So while it is a good initial money maker because it doesn't require any huge investment, just ships, no infrastructure, it is not really something that pays very well. These would be ideal because, if you remember, we cannot really have any vehicles that go faster than 80 right now. Most of them actually go 50 and 60 maybe. The fastest train that we have currently, as you can see, goes exactly 48. So we will probably soon have a train that can go a little faster than this, but it will be quite some time before we can pass 80. And as you can see, all these cargoes are pretty much worthless unless it can go past 80. And they really only take off to get more profitable than the other ones if you reach the high speeds, 130, 150, something like that. So these are the interesting ones. They become profitable up to 80, and then you don't really have to worry about them. So in the early stages where we have slow vehicles, these are the ones that we want. The most profitable one is of course diamonds. We don't have any diamonds in the near vicinity right now. What we do have, however, is building materials. Where do we have building materials, you ask? I will show you in a second. What we also have, maybe, I haven't checked yet, is wood. What we definitely have, because we checked that, is rubber. However, rubber is also something that needs to arrive fast. So what else did we have? Oil. And oil is a very good candidate. What we also had was copper ore. So copper ore and oil are the likely candidates. Wood, if we have it, and building materials, definitely. So where the hell do we have building materials? Well, before I tell you that, let's check whether we have any wood nearby. Let's disable this. And wood should come from a forest. Do we have any forests nearby? Oh, we actually do. And forests go towards... Where do forests actually go to? Where is a forest down here? Is this a forest? No, where was it? Let me check the map again. Forest. Oh, on this side. Okay, there we have a forest, and that goes to a port. Perfect, we have a port. Was this the port? No, this was not the port, but we had a port somewhere here. Wait a second. There was a port somewhere around here. Was it down here? Yes, we had a port down here. I think we had another one over here. Yeah, so we have that, so we could deliver this down there, but I'm not going to do that because I want to get some other industry involved. I want copper over here, oil also over here, and a little down here to this city, and establish a little port here, a little harbor, and get that over to the bulk terminal, which accepts oil and copper ore and in return delivers building materials from our home country. And there we go, building materials. We get them back to here and transport them by rail back here because we have two builders' yards over here. So those are the plans for the future. But for now, let's check whether this actually goes down. Oh yes, that is less. However, this one seems to be still increasing, so let's keep an eye on this. If this goes beyond 1,000 anytime soon, you have to keep an eye on that. However, until then, let's check whether we can actually get this one gone. I don't want the full load order anymore because I want to see whether these ships can handle it on their own. And they actually can. I think one of them might actually be completely enough to handle this. So we might send this ship down here because I will actually do what you guys suggested and I will establish something here. I'm not sure whether I should do that by road or whether I should do it by rail, because I wanted to have a train station here anyway. But delivering this distance with by rail, I don't think that will actually be worth it. So let's go over here first and check how this route is doing. So what does this ship do? It collects all these. I don't think it will be able to catch all that. No, of course not. So if we max out this line, I think we will have a pretty good money maker. What does this ship actually cost? 38,000. Okay, I will speed this up until we have a good number of ships here. I may even put a cut in here. A little in-between update, I introduced, I think, 5 little boats on this little line down here, and that seems to actually reduce the amount of fish here. This one is pretty much overdone. I could split these ships up to only serve this one and only this one, but it's okay. They load at least 50% here, so it's fine. And they do make, which one is this actually? Kadaru. And they also updated our groups here. As you can see, these guys are making profit. It's absolutely fine. So this line is maxed out. And I will continue with this one and get back to you once I have maxed this one out. So see you in a bit. Hey, a little update again, away from our operating profit graph. Sorry that this always opens, that's the same button as me recording, but it will probably also show you how we're doing every now and then. But we had an update. We have a new train available, the 040 Grasshopper. Now, if you don't know what this actually means, these numbers, that is a system to describe a locomotive. This basically means 0 leading wheels, 4 driving wheels, and 0 trailing wheels. The middle number is the wheels that are actually under power, and if there's 2 wheels, it's 1 axle, at least in nearly all cases. The Grasshopper, however, is even a little less powerful than the Planet. That is the first vehicle in the American set. I don't think we're gonna use that. I think we're going to use the Planet. So that's not really that important, but I just wanted to let you know. Let's keep going, this time without a cut. I will just speed this sequence up because I think we're right now making enough money to make this a little quicker. You know what I'll do? I'll make an adjustment to this. While these ships are not capable of handling all of these oil fields, or rather fishing grounds, I'll make an adjustment. I'll let them handle only 2 for starters, and I will add fishing grounds once these are able to do it. I think that's a better way of handling it. Just as a short explanation of what the hell I'm doing here, I'm pretty much keeping an eye on the amount of fish on this one, which seems to be the biggest one. And if the amount of fish on all these fishing grounds goes down, then I have enough ships to add another one. Another fishing ground, that is. If it doesn't go down, I'll add another ship. Okay, this is going to take a while, and since I don't want to spend the entire video of you watching my ships, I'll put a cut in here and come back when I've maxed out this area. And welcome back. Now, we haven't really maxed this out yet, but I added the last fishing grounds up there, and we already have a lot of ships going, as you can see. However, these here, I feel are a little bit far away, especially this one, since we have another fishing harbor here. So my idea is I'm going to establish another port over here, another docks, and grab these three with a different line. So let me set that up real quick. So, we're close to maxing this out, but while we're doing that, I had the feeling that we could maybe do something else as well in the meantime. Now, since we're going to build a lot of stuff around here, maybe down here, and also over here, I think we should establish some passenger networks in these cities. So let's do that. I'm not going to connect the cities just yet, because I want to see what the room will be in here for rail work. But I will certainly establish a passenger network inside the town, so let me do that. And there we go. We have set up passenger service in these two cities. I will keep an eye on that and maybe update it. I think we have a good coverage of these two cities right now. They are not growing because I think we need to deliver food and stuff to them. Oh, this one is actually growing. Okay, that we need to keep an eye on because I don't want them to grow very fast. So we need to keep an eye on that. But let's see how our fish ships are doing, huh? As you can see, Kashalili is dropping, so we have enough ships to handle this line, this entire area. So what remains to be done is maxing out this one. And I will get back to you once I've done that. A short info in between, when we look at our road vehicles, you can see that most of them are not really making a profit. They're not making a huge loss either, that's not the problem. What is, however, a problem is this. Holy cow. So I'm going to update this a little and possibly replace these coaches with bigger ones. So see you in a bit. So I've replaced all the coaches with the fastest ones that were available. They all have the same capacity, 10 passengers, but they're a lot faster now. So they will hopefully make some more profit, and I keep an eye on these numbers. If they still rise, we will add another one. Currently there's 3 male and 3 passenger coaches going on. And up here I also added one more for each line, so there's 2 on their way right now. What are we doing here? Are those numbers dropping? This one is already low. See why I didn't want the hotel connected up? Is this number dropping? Not really dropping, is it? No, we need another one. All right. Let's go down here. These numbers don't seem to be dropping that much either. Nah, they're not dropping, and they will only get more. So let me add another one. What down here? This doesn't seem to be dropping either. I think we can safely say that we need another one down here as well. All these road vehicles are not really making that much money. Next to nothing, actually. They're pretty much out of balance. But that's not a problem. What's important is that, look here, we already have good standing with these cities. And we should also start having good standing with these ones, at least soon. Now that we actually have good ratings. Oh, those ratings are perfect. Okay, here we have outstanding ratings already, that's perfect. Let me check what the ratings are here. Ah, that one's good. That one is getting close. I think those are actually fine. Let me check these ones. Yes, that's fine. That's fine. We have to keep an eye on those, but for now we have pretty good ratings. So everything should be okay. So let's take a look at our fishing again. Oh, this is still going up. We need another ship up here. How's this doing? This is low, so this is pretty much maxed out. This is perfect. Up here. Yeah. I think we can safely say that we need another one right away. But I think with this one, we should be able to max this out. As you can see, we're steadily increasing our income with the ships and our vehicles in general. So this one has already outstanding rating. This one already has excellent rating. And this one should go up now. This one has to drop first a little bit, of course. But I think we should be fine. So with that, I think we are absolutely capable of building stuff, because right now we're making 280,000 a year just with our ships. I think that's perfectly fine for us to start doing something with rail. Don't you agree? We're still making lots with passengers, but I think that's due to the speed. I think once we introduce some long distance train lines and these passenger transports become actually just transfer transports that deliver to the train stations, I'm sure we're okay. Since this city is now growing, I think we should start establishing a rail line coming over here. And I think I'm going to build a rail station right here that is going to be the rail station for the builder's yard. This one we're going to connect up by road, yes, because building materials are not really that speed dependent, so that's not really the problem. So we're going to connect this up by road, we're going to have a train station right here, and we're going to have a rail line coming around here, and there's going to be a mini junction over here that's coming around. I think this location for a train station will be good, because we can have a throughput station, and that location should be best to keep it expandable. I'm not going to make a rail connection right over here. I was thinking about making a rail station right here in this direction, but I think the cities will start to grow into that too soon. And I don't know. I think working out the tracks around here when there's already roads and a church over here, I think that's going to be tricky. And having the station down here might be another idea, but then again, I don't have really that much room to get the tracks laid up there. So having it a little bit further up here is, I think, the better solution. Having it right in the middle here so I can have a little space to work with the tracks and just make a curve around here to the oil. Then come around here, go right across here to this city, make a port here to deliver over here, and come back and deliver back to this city the building materials, which we will also transfer to this one by road. I think that's a good plan. If I put the rail station over here also, I have the advantage that I can probably directly connect this builder's yard. So that's the plan. Hope you agree that this is a solid foundation that we built for ourselves here. We could start grabbing these fishing grounds, but I'm not really a big fan of making a road connection here, because that might interfere with rail networks that we're going to put there in the future. And I think we already grabbed enough fishing grounds to have a solid foundation for our future operation. We're operating on 22 ships right now. We already have some road vehicles in the cities, which help us have a good standing at the cities that we are going to build next to. We're going to add something in here as well, I think, just a little coach going back and forth, so we have a good standing at this one as well, since we have a train, not a train, since we, oh, there's a builder's yard over here too, that's perfect. Oh, I have to check, maybe we can even get the docks working with that one, and otherwise we will do that by road. So we have three builder's yards already that we will deliver to. So since we're going to build next to this one, I want good standing with this one as well. But once we have that in place, everything will be fine. I'm not sure whether we are going to do any passenger network soon, because the speed is so low that I'm not sure whether that's going to be profitable despite having a bunch of hotels. I might make one test line and see whether that train is actually profitable. Then we'll see. If not, if the cities don't grow that much right from the start, it's not that bad. So, that's the plans for the future. Leave me your comments as always. As I mentioned, I want to have this Let's Play a little bit more interactive. So, give me your ideas, your suggestions on what we're going to do next, and what you liked, what you didn't like. By the way, just one last comment. I deactivated the animation for the water. I think that looks a little better with the video compression since we have so much water. I noticed in the last video that gets certain art effects when I speed up time. So I deactivated the animation. That will also make the game run a little bit smoother. So with that, I'll say keep your heads up, folks. I'll see you on the next one.